Hello students, welcome back. So in today's class we'll talk about personality attributes of a housekeeping staff. So let's start. What are the personality attributes? These are basically the qualities what housekeeping staff should possess or what one should possess when he or she is working in the hotel. So what are personality attributes? These are certain qualities which a housekeeping staff should possess in order to perform housekeeping functions, which are sometimes more important than any other skill. So the attributes what one should possess in housekeeping, or in other words we'll say personality attributes of a housekeeping staff, and here's the list: pleasant personality, physical fitness, personal hygiene, eye for detail, cooperation, adaptability, honesty, tactful and diplomatic, right attitude and courteous, calm behavior, punctuality and good memory. So let's start. Pleasant personality. The staff should have a good presentation of one's own self when interacting with guests. The staff should have the good presentation skills or should know how to interact or how to handle the situation when interacting with the guest. This reflects the quality of service and standards in an establishment. This shows that the staff is trained enough to handle the situations or to have a conversation with the guest, and the guest queries can be solved then and there itself. Physical fitness. The housekeeping staff should go through a thorough medical examination and should be fit to perform the housekeeping functions. Housekeeping tasks are quite heavy. One has to perform very hard duties like GRAs or housemen or supervisors. They have to perform hard work. So they should be fit. They should be fit enough to take any kind of task in the housekeeping. That's why the medical examination is required from time to time. Personal hygiene. The housekeeping staff should have healthy skin, clean hair, eyes, teeth, nose, nails and fingers, etc. One should take care of their personal hygiene themselves. It should not be taught, it should come from within. So that's why personal hygiene is very much required. Eye for detail. The staff should possess power of critical observation to make a flawless room and keen sense to inspect rooms for perfection. Eye for detail means one should have a vision of, like, once you are in a room and you just have a look around the room. So you should be able to note down the flaws which are there so that they can be rectified at once. Cooperation. The staff must cooperate with the other staff or other departments and should be a team worker and work more efficiently with them. Cooperation is very much required. Coordination is very much required within the departments and with other departments for the smooth functioning of the hotel. Adaptability. The staff should be able to adapt to new ideas and accept changing situations willingly. According to the housekeeping department, there are many sub-departments. So the staff should be ready to work in any shift, in any sub-department. Like, it is not necessary that you should always work as a GRA. You should be multi-skilled. So your duty can be put under uniform room or linen room, and you should be able to work there accordingly. So that's why adaptability is required. Honesty. The housekeeping staff needs to have this quality as they have access to all the rooms and guest belongings are left lying around. They should also deal with various kind of guest amenities that are very expensive. So they should have inherent discipline and integrity. A GRA who cleans the room, and if it is an occupied room, there must be guest belongings which can be expensive items. A GRA should be, or not only the GRA, the whole staff of the hotel, including housekeeping, should be honest, and they should not touch the guest belongings or take them to use this shows, in case you are not using the guest amenities or any expensive guests, this shows your discipline and the standards of the hotel. Tactful and diplomatic. The housekeeping staff have to handle guest requests and complaints. The guests are fussy and can make unusual requests. The staff have to be tactful and diplomatic to handle these requests. Sometimes the guest complains about anything. Guests can complain about anything. So the staff should be tactful and diplomatic enough to handle that situation. Sometimes the guest requests can be unusual. For example, the size of the room is very small. So in that case, nobody can do anything. So the staff should be diplomatic enough to give replies to the guest, or he should be tactful in handling that situation. Right attitude and courteous. The staff should have right attitude, which displays an even temper, courtesy and good humor, and optimistic in nature. A staff should have right attitude. For example, if a guest is angry and he is shouting, so in return to that, the staff should not shout back at the guest, but they should be like polite enough to handle that situation. A staff should be courteous to both guests and colleagues. The attitude of the staff should be same towards the guests as well as towards his colleagues. Calm behavior. Should be able to handle situations with composed personality and humbleness and politeness. The staff should be able to handle any situation with calm mind, and in case the cooperation of others are required, you should not hesitate to take help of either seniors or your colleagues. Punctuality. The staff should have respect for time during work hours, as this reflects on his or her sincerity. You should be punctual. You should report to duty on time. You should finish your work in time so that no one points you out. And punctuality helps you a lot in your growth. Good memory. Staff should have good memory to remember staff likes, dislikes, needs and wishes of guests, and especially repeat guests. You should have a good memory, and in case you are getting a repeat clientele, repeat guest, you should know his likes or dislikes. Okay, or if it is a new guest, he has told you something, so you should remember that that thing has to be done on daily basis. Let's suppose there's a guest in a room, new guest, who says, I need fresh flowers every day in my room. So you should remember to put those fresh flowers in his room every day. That's about the good memory. So that's all for today, and in the next class we will study about the layout of the housekeeping department. Till then, bye. See you in the next class. Thank you so much.